YouTube, doing another little cooking video for you today. This is 910 Hunter coming at you. Hit that subscribe button, man. It feels so weird saying that, but hit that subscribe button, hit that like button, check out these videos. So today I've already cooked it and everything, and I told y'all that I was going to be bringing you a cooking video talking about some deer meat barbecue and how I do it. I mean, you might have your own recipe, you might never had it this way, so I'm just going to walk you through real quick, very simple recipe of what I like to do, alright? So I'm going to flip the camera around, hang tight. So right, excuse me YouTube, right here on this one, we have the PD Swamp Sauce. Over here I went to Food Lion, picked up Taste of Inspiration's Moonshine Barbecue. Like, I like to be adventurous, try different stuff and everything, but this is normally my wife and I's go-to right here. And as you can tell, I just ate some. I mean, I pigged out. It was so good. So right here, we got the Swamp Sauce, and then we got the Taste of Inspiration Moonshine. I went to Food Lion. I knew we were going to have this one. I went to Food Lion, and I just, like, saw a bunch of barbecue. I just grabbed a bottle off of it. I was just like, kind of Russian roulette it. I'm just going to grab something, roll on with it. And it was actually really good. I think there's probably pepper in this one. It had a little bit of a kick to it, and I like that. There's so much flavor with the Swamp Sauce. So much flavor, and that's why no matter what, we're going to have a pan of the barbecue with the PD Swamp Sauce. I can't forget the swangy. Can't forget the swangy. So let me walk you through real quick of what I do to get these recipes rocking and rolling so I can put it in my belly. That's the only way you can do it. You got to have it good so you can put it down. So one thing is I got to give a shout out to my grandma, because my grandma would cook this recipe or a similar recipe around Thanksgiving and Christmas. And this was always our tradition, is to have deer meat barbecue. And she would normally do it with a regular barbecue sauce. I mean, like the Crafts or something like that. Nothing super crazy or expensive. And then like a teriyaki flavor. It was really good too. And I'm actually going to be doing that next week for Christmas for my family. But she told me this recipe that I have right here on the back. And normally what she, let me just walk you through this recipe, is this is an oven. So you get a turkey roasted oven bag and put, cover the deer meat, backstrap, ham, whatever, and olive oil, and put that. You can put bacon over it, you can put pineapple over it, salt and pepper it, and add some onions, diced onions, you know, some seasoning, whatever y'all want to do, and then cook on 325, so a low temperature, for 4 hours at a, for 4 hours, 325 for 4 hours. And then after that, take it out, let it cool. And then when you let it cool, shred it up with your hands, knife, whatever you may be, and then put it back in the oven with just in a regular pan, you know, a much bigger version of this right here, what I showed y'all, a much bigger version. Take it out of the oven bag, put it in a glass pan or something like that, shred it up, and then put your favorite barbecue sauce. I tried like adding water because I'm from North Carolina. I like that Eastern style liquid base, the vinegar base. But I've had some that were a lot thicker, like Sweet Baby Ray's kind of thick. And I would add a little water to it, but then I realized after a while that it would dilute the actual taste of it. So, and I like it smothered and covered. I think that Larry Cable guy, smothered and covered. So I'll use a whole jar, you know, a whole bottle of it to pour on the deer meat. But, so throw it back in the oven, 350, for about 30 minutes with the barbecue sauce, and let it kind of marinate or let it cook in it and everything. And normally that's really good. Take it out, let it cool, throw it on some bread. You can have it just on a plate, and I mean, it is awesome. But the way I did this, and I've been doing it, is that because it's hunting season, I can't stand over the stove. I'm not one to say, hey, 4 hours in the oven, or the stove, 4 hours in the oven, and I'm going to be doing stuff out and about, doing job stuff, and I'm too scared to leave it there. But I'll put it in one of these bad boys right here called a crock pot. So what I'll do is throughout the week, let the blood drain out. I have it normally. I started doing this so it don't take up much space. Put the deer meat in this, fill it up with water, salt water, a little bit of vinegar. Let that blood drain for 2 to 3 days. Let it out, and then put it in a crock pot with just water and your favorite soda. Or I put Mountain Dew in there and let it cook in there for about 6 hours. Take it out, shred it, put the barbecue sauce on it, and good to rock and roll. I mean, it is really good. And then it looks like this. And I mean, I just had some, and it is awesome. And one thing I've also learned, one tip, is that 2 to 3 days after cooking it, it actually, for me, tastes better because the barbecue sauce actually absorbs into the meat for 2 to 3 days. And I mean, it tastes so good. So like the day after, you know, if you eat it the day of, you cooking it, it's going to be okay. It's going to be pretty good. But I like reheating it in the microwave on some bread or just on a plate. And I mean, that barbecue sauce has had time to absorb into the meat. And I mean, it is awesome. It's really good. So again, you know, go to the local grocery store or whatever. This is, I'm not sponsored by them by no means, but this is a local barbecue place about a block away from Dixie and I's house. And we love their barbecue and we buy their stuff to support them during COVID and everything else. And so I'll be going back there in another day or two to buy some more. So this is what we have locally. I like it. Again, I love to experiment with different stuff and just check out different flavors. I mean, it's a whole new world for me. Like, up until, you know, 8 months ago, I've never cooked this. I've never asked my grandma to the recipe until just a minute, you know, just a little bit ago. But yeah, YouTube, get creative. Like I said, throw it in the crock pot with your soda, with some seasoning, whatever you want. Let it cook for 6 hours. Take it out, shred it, put it in a glass pan. Throw it in the oven for about 30 minutes on 325 or 350. And let that barbecue sauce cook in with the meat. Have yourself a meal. Y'all take care, YouTube. Get in the woods, do some hunting. Yee-yee!